Hello, and welcome to Math Matters. I'm Mrs. Parker. In today's episode, we're going to use a three-act task called Chasing Gold by Graham Fletcher. During today's three-act task, Chasing Gold, you'll be working with decimals to determine who will win a race. Here are some materials you will need for today. You will need a piece of paper and a pencil. As you are working today, you will have an opportunity to practice your communicator skills by sharing your ideas through writing and working to make connections with what you read and hear throughout the lesson. To get our brains thinking about math, we're going to do a warm-up activity called Which One Doesn't Belong? Look at the four pictures. Three of the pictures go together in one way, while the fourth one doesn't belong. There isn't a wrong answer as long as you can explain why. Are you ready? Which one doesn't belong and why? Write down your thoughts on your piece of paper. Number one doesn't belong because the numbers follow a pattern with four digits in the bottom, then three digits, then two digits, and finally one digit on top. Number two doesn't belong because it's the only square that goes into the millions place. Number three doesn't belong because it doesn't follow the pattern like the other three. In box one, two, and four, the numbers grow by multiplying each number by the same number. For example, 7 times 10 equals 70, then 70 times 10 is 700, and finally, 700 times 10 is 7,000. Number 4 doesn't belong because it's the only square that has a number smaller than 1 and uses 5/10. Did you think of the same ones? Put a check mark next to the ones that we had the same. Put a star next to the ones that you had that I didn't have that are different. And write down any more that you can think of. In a moment, you are going to watch a video. As you watch, think about who will win the race. What's your prediction? Based on what you saw, who do you think will win the race? Write down your prediction on your piece of paper, as well as why you think that she will win the race. We are trying to solve the problem of who will win this race. Think back to our question. In order for you to solve this problem, you need to know some information. What do you need to know in order to answer this question of who will win the race? Write down some things you will need to know. In order to solve this problem, we need to know how the racers performed. Look at the chart. Which column do we need to use to help us solve the problem of who won the race? We need to look at the result column to determine who won the race. Now that you have this new information, try to solve the problem. Are the results in order of who was the fastest? No. The results are in order by the lane assignments for each runner. Before we determine who won the race, let's put the results in order from the fastest to the slowest runner. Use your piece of paper and a pencil, and use a strategy of putting the decimals in order from fastest to slowest. Remember that we're using the results column for finishing times. One strategy that we can use is a number line. Why do you think I have 10 n 70 hundredths on one end and 11 on the other end? I use these two numbers as my benchmarks because most of the runners finish between those times. How many runners took longer than 11 seconds to run the race? Only one runner, Christina Williams, took longer than 11 seconds to run the race. If she took longer than 11 seconds, did she come in first or last in the race? She came in last. I have an unmarked line in the middle between 10 and 70 hundredths and 11 on my number line. What number could this represent? The unmarked line in the middle between 10 and 70 hundredths and 11 is 10 and 85 hundredths. Now there are two more unmarked lines in the number line. What numbers could these lines represent? These lines could be 10 and 77 hundredths and 10 and 92 hundredths. Now look at the racers. Could you place each racer's time on the number line? Use your piece of paper to place each racer on the number line. Looking at the number line, was the race close? Who won the race? Watch the video to see if you are right.
Set. And who's got the best start? It's pretty even, but Shelly-Ann Fraser-Price trying to come away, but Elaine Thompson on the far side, and it's Thompson who's going to become the Olympic champion.
Elaine Thompson won the race. How do you know that she won the race? We know that she won the race because she has the fastest time, or it took her the least amount of seconds to run the race. Before we go, let's reflect. If you try to solve the problem again, what would you do differently? What are you still wondering after watching this lesson? Write down one reflection on your piece of paper. In today's episode of Math Matters, we reviewed comparing and ordering decimals. This is Mrs. Parker, and I hope you have a wonderful day.